tell me, what was it about the script that drew your attention?
Michael Keaton and Carol Burnett. And before I even read the script, I knew they were attached, and I was like, I'm on board. And then I did read the script, because I am a, you know, conscientious type of person, so I do investigate those things, and I thought that the script was rather funny, and I really liked Vicky, our director, and so I was excited. So I grew up with her. She was the favorite show of the week for my entire family, and, you know, I always knew that I wanted to be an actress, and I always knew I wanted to do comedy, and what she was doing up there on the screen was exactly what I saw myself in my wildest dreams doing. And it looked like so much fun. It looked like they were having so much fun, and I was like, I want to do that. A little way late, and we all do, but when you have that ambition and that hopefulness and that kind of bright-eyed optimism, and to have that dashed is really crushing. Mm-hmm. You know, and that is exactly what happened for her, and she had to move back home with her insane family.
But a fun one.
A fun one, yes. But she doesn't embrace the malbiness, insanity of the family at first. She has to learn to love that. You know, after college, I ended up doing a string of really unsatisfying, terrible grunt work jobs, and I was in New York, and it's very hard to live in New York if you're not happy. And I was a miserable little girl, and I ended up moving back to Chicago, where I'm from, and the South Side, to a suburb, and moved into my family home at the age of 24, the house I grew up in, and went back into the bedroom that I grew up in with all the same furniture. It looked exactly the same as it did when I was in high school, and I kind of licked my wounds for about a year before I went back out and tried to do it on my own. I think that Second City people, especially the, you know, not just the touring ones, but the people who create the shows, you have to be kind of smart and kind of politically aware and funny and have an interesting take on it. And I can say that humbly because I wasn't one of them. I just toured. I didn't open one of those shows, but I know the people that were there that ended up opening shows that were in my generation at that time, like Steve Colbert and Steve Carell and Tina Fey, who I didn't know, but she was there slightly after me. But that, you know, that's the kind of actor that Second City produces. And I love, for me, that is fun. And I love being part of a group. I love ensemble comedy. I love working with other people where you support each other. And it's more about the quality of the scene than it is about anybody, you know, being a breakout star or, you know, in doing the 40-Year-Old Virgin and Talladega Nights and all of those movies, Role Models, it was the best joke wins. It doesn't matter, you know, if Will Ferrell got to do the good joke or if I got to do it or Gary Cole or whoever, it's best joke wins. Well, in this economy, I'll bet there's a lot of graduates out there who are having a hard time finding a job, and perhaps this will give them some hope or be able to laugh at their situation. But also there's such sweet chemistry between Zach and Alexis and their little budding love story. And then, of course, Carol Burnett and Michael Keaton, you know, as her crazy family. And you know, that's a treat to see the two of them on the screen together. And I was lucky enough to, you know, share it with them.